Hi there, I'm Chris Berman. Here we go on ESPN. The fabled columns are still there, but it looks as if a spaceship has landed on top of them. Nevertheless, they're set for football. Past, present, future. The Windy City of Chicago. Minneapolis, Chicago. Straight ahead. Future.
And look at all the happy tailgaters as they get set to cheer for the hometown team. Hi, folks, it's Dan Stevens, and welcome to Chicago Field. And my sidekick, Peter O'Keefe. Peter, both of these teams have, some very talented players holding down the safety positions. Wouldn't you agree?
No question about it, Dan. Safeties are often literally the last line of defense, and these are reliable as they come.
Number 38, he's a very talented free safety. What's extraordinary about this guy is his stamina. As the game wears on, he gets more and more dominant. Warming up across the field is another tremendous football player. Smith is a Pro Bowl free safety, ranking among the very best in the game. What I love about this guy is his agility. He can stay with a receiver to knock down a pass or make an open field tackle. I tell you what, Dan, both these guys have potential to light it up today.
Okay, Peter, we'll see how they do once the game begins, but first, the toss of the coin.
It's tails.
Number three, kicking off for the Vikings.
There's the signal, and we're ready. Number three kicks it off to begin the game. Thompson decides to take it out of the end zone. Breaks free, dragged down at the 22.
Thompson got out close to the 20 on that one, so his decision to take it out of the end zone didn't really pay off, but it didn't really hurt him either.
The Bears offense takes the field, and they will start at their own 22-yard line. Number 33 picks up a yard on the play, and that will bring up second down.
Dan, bunch of receivers out there. Defense is expecting that, and they go to nickel.
Number 6 throws a bullet to the flat, and it's incomplete.
Number 33, set up for the screen back there. He had blockers ready, but forgot to catch the ball.
Third down, 9 yards to go. Number 33 rips down the lob, and he will be well short of the markers. It'll be fourth down.
Number 54 targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
That's his second tackle so far. Number 16 lines up to punt after the three and out. Number 16 gets the ball and punts it away. Number 35 fields the punt at the 35. Stopped at the 44.
Number 35 did a nice job getting some yards after fielding the solid punt.
The Vikings will start this first play of the drive at their 44-yard line. Diggs makes the nice catch and gets past the markers for a first down. First down from the shotgun. Bradford rifles it out left side and it's tipped. Incomplete. Johnson makes the catch on the right sideline, and he's got the first down and a whole lot more.
Check that out. Those last year numbers are solid.
Number 44 will get the handoff and takes it upfield, and he's in for the touchdown.
Come on, give it up, baby.
Oh, I love watching great plays like this again. It's great the first time around, but it's really sweet on the replay. Oh, I just can't get enough of this action. What a tremendous display of athleticism.
Number three to attempt the extra point. Number 67, holding.
Here's the point after, and it's good.
Number three, kicking off for the Vikings.
The ref gets the signal, and we're set. Number three, rockets this one deep. Bellamy decides to take it out of the end zone. Tackled at the 19.
Bellamy got out close to the 20 on that one, so his decision to take it out of the end zone didn't really pay off, but it didn't really hurt him either.
Bears stalled early last drive, and we'll have to wait and see what happens here. They'll start at their own 19-yard line. Rhodes tips it away on the coverage, incomplete.
Rhodes knocked that pass down, and he made sure the only one to touch the football was him.
A nice throw down the field, but the defense plays it perfectly.
Great coverage downfield that time.
Second down, three wideouts in the game. Number six throws this on a rope, and it's tipped, incomplete.
Rhodes came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
A nice defensive play will give him his second batted ball of the game.
Yeah, great read there.
Ball of the Bears, 19-yard line.
Bellamy catches the hard throw, and they get the first on third and long.
Bellamy faces down two defenders and comes away with the football. Oh, nice catch.
Third and long, and they get the big play to convert. What do you think of that, Peter?
I love it. That's what football is all about, making the big plays when you need to, and you can't coach that.
Number six fires this one over the middle, and the catch is made well past the markers for a first down.
Face mask, number 27, defense. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Curse clearly tugs on the face mask here. You just can't do that and get away with it. Check it out. Yep, there's the flag. Definite face mask. That's a personal foul.
First down with the tight end right.
Ball at the 30-yard line.
Number 33 gets the toss and gets past the line. Brought down at the 24.
Second and four.
Liz,
ball
at
the 24-yard line.
Anyone's mine? Anyone's mine? Hey, I got 17.
Number 33 gains 13 yards, and that brings up first down.
Impressive yards on the ground here. Check it out. Boy, that's some nice running. It's all about field vision. And if you can see where you have room to roam, good things happen.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chain.
Great execution.
Thompson goes in motion. Number number 17 didn't haul that one in, and it falls incomplete.
Number 17 staked out some turf in the middle back there, but was not able to reel in the catch. Incompletion.
That's the third incompletion his way, Peter.
Yeah, and he's starting to look a little frustrated down there, too.
Number 6 throws a bullet to the flat, and the catch is made for a gain of a couple.
Number 17 had a defender close by but was able to bring down the catch.
Peter, I'm sure he's happy to bring that one in. The last three passes to him have all been incompletion.
Yeah, he's struggling a bit there, but this may turn him around.
No dice, and it falls incomplete. That will bring up fourth down. You ain't getting nothing past me. Fourth down, and the field goal unit is on the field. Number 12, holding. Number 4, from 26 yards out, and it's up through the goal post. Good.
Number 4 has no problem getting this one between the sticks for 3. Oh, he was so close. He could have made that if he was wearing wooden clogs.
Well, unfortunately, I have a feeling we'll never know for sure. The ref gets the signal, and we're set. Number 4 booms a beauty here. This will fly out of the end zone for a touchback. What a kick. The Vikings had an effective first drive, and we'll see if they can keep it up. They'll start at their own 20-yard line. Number 44 will get stopped at the line, and that brings up second down.
Jones targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
They put a stop to this play behind the line of scrimmage. Pretty good call by the defensive coordinator.
Agreed, Dan. They had it all locked up there.
That will bring up second down. Floyd hammers the receiver and forces him to drop the ball. Incomplete.
LeBlanc didn't let much daylight get between him and his assignment. Nice coverage to force the incompletion.
That'll give us a third down, and the defense was ready for that call.
Well played, and a good job of not giving up the short pass.
Third down and 4 wideouts in the game.
LeBlanc brought down the ball carrier before the markers. There was some gain there, but not enough for the first.
They stopped them cold. Fourth coming up.
Exactly what this defense needed to do.
Number 18 lines up for the punt. Number 19 to make the return. Number 18 takes the long snap and punts it away. Royal catches it at the 35. Tackled at the 43.
Royal racked up a few yards on the run back there, whittling down the size of the punt a little bit.
The Bears send their offense out on the field and will start this drive at their 43-yard line. Number 33 barges off right guard and will gain close to 6. Second down, 1 man back. Rhodes makes a play on this and forces the incompletion.
Rhodes couldn't have read that play any better if it was tattooed on the inside of his helmet.
That is their 4th batted ball. Tell you, we've seen a number of good defensive plays from this squad.
We sure have. We'll see if they can keep it up, though.
Number 6 throws a heater and it's off, incomplete. With the deflection. Yeah, Number 16 lines up to punt after the three and out.
Number 35 to make the return.
Number 16 gets the snap and punts it away. The Vikings stalled early last drive, and we'll have to wait and see what happens here. They'll start at their own 20-yard line. Number 44 gets the call on first down and picks up a couple.
Number 96 with the tackle. Second and 8. Ball to the Vikings, 22-yard line.
Number 44 gets the call again and heads left. Tackled at the 24.
Third down.
Bradford uncorks this to the left sideline, and they get the first on third and long.
Bradford gets this one past the secondary quite easily. I think the safeties were out of position on that one, Dan. Now, that kind of accuracy is hard to cover, Dan. He knew where he wanted the ball to go, and that's where it went.
And the first time he goes down the field, Peter, he hooks up with his receiver. What a throw.
Oh, boy. We'll see if they can keep up the long game.
First down from the eye. Johnson catches it over the middle and gets past the markers for a first down.
Bradford zeroed in with the pass back there and leaves the two defenders empty-handed. What ball placement.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chains.
And let me tell you, Dan, hearing those chains move is one of the best sounds in the game for an offense.
Him way back at the 48.
The Bears need only three linemen here to get to the quarterback.
Great hit.
Oh.
Yeah, makes you wonder what they would have used a fourth lineman for.
Well, he could have stood back and taken pictures for the defense's scrapbook.
The defensive design worked flawlessly, and the refs will spot the ball well behind the original line of scrimmage.
What a way to derail a series from the onset.
Second and long ahead. Diggs grabs the rope right side and tries to get free.
Touchdown.
He's in for the touchdown.
Diggs keeps the party going after making the catch right here. And now he's off for more. Coaches love receivers who believe his job is just starting when he makes the catch.
That touchdown is going to establish some distance between them, Peter.
That's a big score.
Number 67, holding.
Here's the extra point, and it's good.
Yeah, right here. All the way, man.
Number 3 kicking off for the Vikings.
There's the signal and we're ready. Number 3 booms a beauty here. Thompson downs this in the end zone for a touchback.
Thank you. No touchdown.
The Bears get their offense on the field and will start this drive at their own 20-yard line. Number 6 rifles it out left side and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Smith knocked that pass down. Man, he made sure the only one to touch the football was him.
You know, as a team, they are batting down passes left and right. That is their 6th so far.
Wow, great anticipation of the pass.
Second down, 10 yards to go. number 54, tips it away on the coverage, incomplete.
Number 54 came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
Another batted ball, and they have been attacking the pass every chance they get.
That's right, Dan. You know, why simply defend the pass when you can obliterate it?
Number 6 just rifles this one, and it's knocked down at the line, incomplete. Fourth down coming up.
Griffin swatted that pass away right at the line.
Well, the D holds tight on third and long and forces an incompletion. That was a good call by the defensive coordinator.
Oh, it sure was. Perfect D for that situation.
And it will bring up fourth down. Number 16 lines up deep in his own territory to punt it away. Number 16 takes the snap and punts it away. Number 35 fields the punt at the 37. Stopped at the 44.
Number 35 didn't have much room to work with back there. The special team squad made sure he couldn't respond to that really nice punt.
The Vikings' offense has been effective with the long passes. Will they keep it up? Well, we're going to find out as they start off at their 44-yard line. Johnson goes in motion. Bradford rifles it out left side, and it's good for a gain of 8.
Number 22 with the tackle.
Bradford is showing off some precision passing out there, Dan. Clearly, he's exploiting the short game so far, and he's got 143 yards and one touchdown.
Second and one. Ball at 48 yards.
Number 44 gains 3 yards, and that will bring up first down.
First down, Vikings.
Check air, check air.
First and 10. Ball at 45.
Number 44 carries it for the sixth time and gains about 3 yards.
Ball carrier. Number 29 with the tackle.
Second down, two tight ends in the game.
Ball at the 42-yard line.
Diggs didn't haul that one in, and it falls incomplete.
Floyd shadowed the slant route back there and kept the receiver from making the catch. Incomplete pass.
On second down, they try for the first, but it's played well by the defense. That will bring up third down.
Nice pressure that time.
Bradford throws a bullet, and it is not reeled in. Incomplete.
Number 19 found a spot in the middle on that last play, but couldn't connect with the ball. No catch.
Peter, in third down situations, they have not been successful at all with the pass. This play was more proof.
Boy, third is such a crucial down, Dan. And when you don't convert, it really hurts.
Number 18 gets ready to punt this away. Number 18 gets the snap and punts it away. The Bears have had some trouble moving the ball recently. We'll see what they do on this drive as they start at their own 20-yard line. Number 6 zips it to the left sideline, and they can't connect. Incomplete. Number 17 catches it left sideline and is well past the markers for a first down.
Number 17 makes a good gain here and gets past the marker. That's nice execution. Let's have a look. He got what he needed and then went out of bounds. Nice play.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chains.
Great execution.
And that'll do it for quarter number one. The Vikings enjoying a lead 14-3. Number six zings it to the right side, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Barr knocked that pass down, and he made sure the only one to touch the football was him.
A nice defensive play will give him his second batted ball of the game.
Yeah, great read there.
Second down, both wide outs to the right. Hurst puts a lick on the receiver and separates him from the ball. Incomplete.
Number 29 with the coverage. Third and 10. Ball to the Bears 34-yard line.
Single back. Single back.
Number six fires this one over the middle, and this one is incomplete.
Number 81 looked like he was all over that one, but it just got away somehow. Tough incompletion.
The incompletions keep piling up, and even here in the second quarter, it doesn't seem to be improving.
Not at all. They're just not getting it together. The timing, the routes, the protection, nothing.
Number 16 gets ready to punt this away. Number 16 gets the ball and punts it away. Number 35 fields it at the 21. Dragged down at the 30.
Number 35 racked up a few yards on the run back there, whittling down the size of the punt a little bit.
The Vikings come out on offense and are well ahead. They have yet another shot to score and start this drive at their own 30-yard line. Bradford throws a heater, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Number 38 got himself in prime position to bat away that football before the receiver even had a shot at it.
That had potential for some yards, Peter, but the defense was on top of it and shut it down.
Good denial there.
Second down coming up. Number 44 will get the carry on second down and chews up about four on the play. Number 93 sacks him back at the 31. That will bring up fourth down. Number 18 lines up to punt after the three and out. Number 18 takes the long snap and pummels this one deep. Royal fields the deep punt at the 23. Tackled at the 33. It looks like, we've had an injury down on the field. As soon as we hear anything, we'll be sure to pass the information along to you. The Bears offense has to score here. This drive will start at their 33-yard line. Number six fires this one over the middle, and the reception is made past the markers for a first down.
Number six knows how to spread the ball around, as you can see by this passing chart. He's getting the ball into his receiver's hands and has piled up 64 yards and no touchdowns.
Number 17 hauls it in right side and gets past the markers for a first down.
Number number 17. Had three guys covering him on this play, and he still made the catch. I don't know if it was a good effort by him or a bad one by the defense. It could have been both. Oh, it's hard to believe that play worked.
I'm glad he finally nabbed one because he's had a string of missed catches before this.
Yeah, his quarterback obviously didn't lose faith in him, though, Dan, because he's kept throwing it his way.
Number 6. Throws a bullet, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Number 54 came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
Another batted ball, and they have been attacking the pass every chance they get.
That's right, Dan. You know, why simply defend the pass when you can obliterate it?
Number 17 grabs the fastball over the middle and is well past the markers for a first down.
Number 17 is matched up well with the defense on this one, but is able to stay one step ahead for the completion. It's worth another look here. Oh, yeah, the D might want to put more men on him next time.
Beautiful catch, Peter, and his stats are moving up.
Moving way up, Dan. He's now got 57 yards on 5 catches.
Number 6 zips it to the left sideline, and it's good for a gain of 8. Eason was shaken up earlier, and I hear Susie Culber has a report for us. Susie?
Thanks, Dan. He came off the field complaining of lower leg pain, and the trainers are saying he's got a high ankle sprain. They're putting a brace on him, but it's taking longer than they expected. It's unclear whether he'll be able to get back into this one. Back to you.
As always, we'll hope for the best up here in the booth. Thank you. Number 81 goes in motion. Number 33 picks up about 2, and that brings up third down.
Number 33 used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Not much there, but they'll get another shot on third and short. Number 33 gets the call again and jukes to a first down.
Number 33 beat his man with a sweet little juke move back there.
A big gain on third, and they will easily move the chain.
Perfect call for the situation, Dan. No trouble in getting the first.
It's intercepted. No one in front of him. Runs out at the 22.
Green made a huge play there, not only picking off the pass, but moving the ball forward afterwards.
Boy, that was a heads-up play to come away with his first interception of the game.
Yeah, you gotta love D like that.
The Vikings are going to try and capitalize on the interception. They'll start this drive at their own 22-yard line. Diggs goes in motion. Bradford zings it to the right side, and the reception is made past the markers for a first down.
Diggs reels in the pass despite nearly getting squeezed by two defenders.
There's the catch and the double coverage. They really didn't phase him there.
Maybe they ought to send in a third.
That's another medium-range catch for him. He's really found his niche in there.
Yeah, and unless he starts getting shut down, there's no reason for him to move out of it. Well, those are some impressive numbers. Look at those receiving yards.
Number 54 will get the carry on first down and only gets back to the line of scrimmage.
Young not only cleaned the ball carrier's clock in the backfield, but buffed and polished it, too. Big hit for a loss.
That's his second tackle so far. Bradford fires this one over the middle, and it is not reeled in. Incomplete.
Young stayed so close to his assignment, he could have taken his calls for him. Incomplete pass.
On second down, they try for the first, but it's played well by the defense. That will bring up third down.
Nice pressure that time.
Third down and 4 wideouts in the game. Number 44 catches the lob over the middle and is at the 45. Brought down hard at the 47. That will bring up first down.
Number 44 goes Hollywood here with a nifty move after the catch. Nice. Gotta love a guy who not only can make those moves, but can get big yards off him, too.
A nice run after the catch, and that's what they expect from him.
Heck, that's his job description. You won't see him running a post route, but you will see him make plays off those shorter catches.
Diggs goes in motion. Floyd penetrates and stops that back at the 49.
Floyd makes a nice stop in the backfield here, throwing his man into the turf behind the line. I guess the ball carrier's travel plans were canceled. Yep, he's not going anywhere, Dan. Nice tackle.
They put a stop to this play behind the line of scrimmage. Pretty good call by the defensive coordinator.
Agreed, Dan. They had it all locked up there.
That will bring up second down. Diggs snags the dart right sideline and picks up four on the play. Bradford gets all of his arm into this pass, and it's tipped. Incomplete. Fourth down coming up.
LeBlanc knocked that pass down, and he made sure the only one to touch the football was him.
Well, the knee holds tight on third and long and forces an incompletion. That was a good call by the defensive coordinator.
Oh, it sure was. Perfect D for that situation.
And it will bring up fourth down. Number 18 takes the snap and punts it away. Royal fair catches it at the 13. Well, Peter, some interesting information up on the screen.
Oh, you bet. Well, punting is not going to win you a game, although it looks like they are trying to do that. They need to put a drive together and get into the end zone.
The Bears were intercepted last time out. We'll see what happens here. We'll start at their own 13-yard line. Number 81 goes in motion. Number 6 just rifles this one, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Number 29 with the deflection.
Number 6 has had difficulties, to say the least, and now he's second-guessing everything he's throwing. Terrible day. So far, he's struggled to get 101 yards and one interception.
Second down, three wideouts in the game.
Bears 13-yard line.
Rhodes makes a play on this one and forces the incompletion.
Rhodes got himself in prime position to bat away that football before the receiver even had a shot at it.
He records yet another batted ball, and I'll tell you, he's really playing well out there.
Yeah, he's been after the ball from the beginning of the game. Real aggressive play. Joseph made the save, dropping the ball carrier before he could get to the markers.
They stopped them cold. Fourth coming up.
Exactly what this defense needed to do.
Number 16 lines up deep in his own territory to punt it away. Number 16 takes the snap and punts it away. Number 35 fields the punt at the 41. Brought down at the 47.
Number 35 racked up a few yards on the run back there, whittling down the size of the punt a little bit.
The Vikings had their last drive stall out at the end. We'll see if they can keep momentum throughout this one, which starts at the 47-yard line. Number 44 gets past the line and picks up a couple.
Number 44 had blockers on his side on that last play, but the defense was too smart. It gave him nowhere to go.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
Number 44 will take the handoff and will lose about a yard here.
Number 59 targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
Nice job eliminating any forward progress on that play. That will bring up a third and long.
Defense!
him down in the backfield, and that takes them even farther away from the markers. It'll be fourth down. Number 18 lines up to punt after the three and out.
Number 19 to make the return.
Number 18 gets the snap and punts it away. Royal fair catches it at the 11. The Bears can climb back into it with a score before half here. They will start this drive at their own 12-yard line. Number 6 fires this one over the middle, and he's on target for a gain of 5.
Number 6 made a nice throw there, got it right past the defender.
That's another pass that went pretty much down the middle. He hasn't been working the sides too much.
Well, he's obviously very confident to be throwing into where all the traffic is. He's daring the D to stop him.
Miller catches this one and gets past the markers for a first down.
Number 6 makes a terrific completion in double coverage here.
Wow, now that is one confident QB.
Another short pass, and he likes that area of the field so far.
And why not? He's had success there.
Number 17 goes in motion. Number 33 gets his 7th carry of the game and will gain close to 6.
Number 33 played smart and used his blockers to perfection on that last play.
They move the ball, and it will be second down. Second down, just a single receiver on the field. Number 33 gains 3 yards, and that'll do it for the first half of this one. The Vikings enjoying the lead 14-3. And now let's send you to Chris Berman in our studios in Bristol for the ESPN Halftime Report. Boomer?
Okay, Dana, we'll get back to you guys in a moment. Welcome, everybody, to the ESPN Halftime Show. I'm Chris Berman. A look at our halftime stats here, and boy, look at the difference in passing yards. The Vikings are winning because of it. Let's see if they can keep up their dominance in the second half. Let's get started on this one early in the first quarter. Charles Johnson ran a terrific route here and was able to pull this one in. A 38-yard play that set up a Viking touchdown. The Vikings get the first points of the game and go up by 7. Dub Bears later on in the first, number 6, would drop back and deliver a strike on this one. That set up a big-time 56-yard field goal. The Vikes answering right back. Vikes up by 4. Number 14 was definitely a key as he was able to work his way open for a big one here. They're now up by 11. Dub Bears on defense, number 52, was in the right place at the right time, as his interception was a possible momentum shifter. Bears down 14-3. Number 44 found a soft spot on the defense and it worked to his advantage. And that's where we'll leave this one. Bears are down at the half, 14-3. It's time now for our Halftime Hero Award, which recognizes the most dominant player of the first half. Duh. This time, there can be no question. Number 14 has played like a man possessed. So that'll do it from here. Let's send you back out now to Dan Stevens and Peter O'Keefe. Dan?
Thanks, Chris. And today's game has been presented in ESPN Game Sound, designed and developed in collaboration with Dolby, the leader in surround sound technology. The Vikings get the ball first this half, and another score by them could really open up this game. They currently lead 14-3. Let's go down to the field. Number 4 kicks it, and the second half has now started. Number 84 downs this in the end zone for a touchback. The Vikings stalled early last drive, and we'll have to wait and see what happens here. They'll start at their own 20-yard line. Johnson goes in motion. Floyd makes a play on this and forces the incompletion.
Floyd swatted that one away cleanly. The receiver didn't have a prayer in getting that one.
That is their fourth batted ball. Tell you, we've seen a number of good defensive plays from this squad.
We sure have. We'll see if they can keep it up, though.
Number 93 gets the sack at the 17.
Number 93 dismantled that play by bringing down the quarterback for a loss of yardage.
Peter, he's really gotten after the quarterback in this game.
Oh, you can say that again. So far, he's got two tackles and two sacks.
Number 44 pulls in a lob here, and he's well short of the markers. It'll be fourth down.
Jones brought down the ball carrier before the markers. There was some gain there, but not enough for the first.
That will be his fourth tackle, and he's hitting hard out there in the secondary.
Well, he's making them think twice before going his direction.
Number 18 gets ready to punt this away. Number 18 takes the long snap and punts it away. Royal takes it at the 36. Tackled at the 46.
Royal did a nice job getting some yards after fielding the solid punt.
The Bears start this one on the center logo at their 46-yard line. Number 33 carries it for the ninth time and gains about 3 yards.
Second and six. All of the Bears, 49-yard line.
Number six unloads this one to the left, and the ball is caught at the 28. Touchdown!
Number 17 is going to make the catch. Right there, but that's only the beginning. Look at him chew up the yardage.
Wasn't supposed to be a touchdown pass, but he made it one with that terrific run after the catch.
He fights for every inch he can get out there, so you don't leave any daylight between him and the end zone. As you can see, he's up over the century mark. Oh, he came to play today.
Now the extra point, and it's good. The ref gets the signal, and we're set. This will fly out of the end zone for a touchback. What a kick. Well, Peter, some interesting information up on the screen.
Oh, you bet. Look at how many times they've had to punt it away. They've got to put a few longer drives together and get into the end zone.
First and 10, Minnesota.
McMahon tips it away on the coverage, incomplete.
Bradford is checking off his receivers, finding the open man, and that's evident as you review the chart here. Note the short passes and how that's enabled him to rack up 182 yards and one touchdown.
Second down, two receivers to the left. Bradford rifles it out left side, and the reception is made past the markers for a first down.
Diggs had three guys covering him, but look what happens.
Incredible catch.
The balls are coming his way in the middle, and he's making them pay. You have to like his performance so far.
Well, Dan, I like any receiver who's willing to go over the middle and sacrifice the body to make the catch. Look, Dan, great receiving yards there. That will help your fantasy team.
Number 44 picked up about 7, and that brings up second down.
Berger cleared out a huge lane for the ball carrier back there. Had 10 or 15 more lanes, and he would have had a bowling alley.
Peter, what a nice pickup to get them into a second and short situation.
Yeah, great play, and now they have a bunch of options on what to try next.
Bradford throws a bullet to the flat, and it falls incomplete.
Holding, number 76, offense. 10-yard penalty from the spot.
Boom, held his man on that play, and hey, you can't do that. That was offensive holding any day of the week.
Second down, one man back. Number 38 tips it away on the coverage, incomplete.
Number 38 managed to disrupt things. He got in there and he smacked that pass away. Great D.
You know, as a team, they are batting down passes left and right. That is their sixth so far.
Wow, great anticipation of the pass.
Bradford throws a heater right sideline, and it is not reeled in. Incomplete.
Charles Johnson positioned himself on the outside back there, but the ball didn't position itself in his hands. No catch.
Peter, in third down situations, they have not been successful at all with the pass. This play was more proof.
Boy, third is such a crucial down, Dan. And when you don't convert, it really hurts.
Number 18 gets the ball and punts it away. Tackled at the 33.
Royal returned for a few there, but after that gigantic punt, it was like tearing a single page out of War and Peace. It doesn't make much of a dent.
The Bears bring their offense on the field and will start this drive at their 33-yard line. Number 17 goes in motion. Number 6 rifles this one hard over the middle, and the catch is made well past the markers for a first down.
Miller makes the catch with 3 defenders on his case.
I just don't know why the throw was made into triple coverage.
Hey, it worked.
Yes, it did. A lot of short completions like that today, Peter, where they get stopped right soon after the catch.
Yeah, if you can't make anything happen after the catch, those short throws are useless.
Number 33 has his number called on first down and chews up about 4 on the play.
What the counter?
Second and 6. Ball at 45.
Number 6 zings it to the right side and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Number 54 came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
That's his third batted ball, and he is doing his part, that is for sure.
Nice to see aggressive D like that, Dan.
Third down, 6 yards to go. Number 17 goes in motion. Number 17 grabs the bullet, and they get the first on third and long.
Number 17 reels in the pass despite nearly getting squeezed by 2 defenders.
There's the catch and the double coverage. They really didn't phase him there.
Maybe they ought to send in a third.
Peter, yet another grab here in the third, and he's been working hard the whole game.
It's all about consistency, and he's been that today. What a player. Hey, I like those stats. Great receiving yards.
Number 6 throws this on a rope, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
VAR managed to disrupt things. He got in there and he smacked that pass away. Great D.
A nice defensive play will give him his second batted ball of the game.
Yeah, great read there.
Ball at the 31. Richter! Richter! We back! We
back! I got 2 in here! They couldn't connect on this one. Incomplete.
With the deflection.
Nope, nothing. Let's go, Bears! Come on, we
Third down, and this is the seventh play of the drive. Number six lobs this one way over the middle, and it's tipped. Incomplete. Fourth down coming up.
Smith swatted that one away cleanly. The receiver didn't have a prayer in getting that one.
Another batted ball, and they have been attacking the pass every chance they get.
That's right, Dan. You know, why simply defend the pass when you can obliterate it?
Fourth down, and the field goal unit is on the field. Number four boots it from 48 yards out, and he misses this one to the right.
Number four misses the field goal here. Let's watch this again. Yep, it's just a little bit to the side of the upright, but close only counts in horseshoes.
The Vikings haven't got much out of their offense recently, and we'll see if they can get back on track here. This drive begins at their 39-yard line. Bradford throws a heater right sideline, and it's intercepted.
Porter does a great job diving in there to rescue the pass before it hits the turf. Ooh, just gets to it. Hey, I'm amazed he came away with that one, actually.
Boy, that was a heads-up play to come away with his first interception of the game.
Yeah, you gotta love D like that.
The Bears are going to try and capitalize on the interception. They'll start this drive at their 47-yard line. Number 17 goes in motion. Rhodes makes a play on this and forces the incompletion.
Rhodes swatted that one away cleanly. The receiver didn't have a prayer in getting that one.
He records yet another batted ball. And I'll tell you, he's really playing well out there.
Yeah, he's been after the ball from the beginning of the game. Real aggressive play.
Number six throws a bullet to the flat, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Barr swatted that one away cleanly. The receiver didn't have a prayer in getting that one.
If complete, that would have made for a bit shorter third down play, but the defense had other ideas.
The anticipation to the throw was key here. It made all the pieces fall into place.
Third down coming up. Slides down at the 44. That will bring up fourth down.
Number six tried to make something happen back there, but nothing doing.
Number 16 lines up to punt after the three and out.
Number 35 to make the return.
Number 16 gets the snap and punts it away. Number 35 fields the punt at the 12. Stopped at the 16.
Number 35 fielded the ball, and although he was dropped pretty quickly, that terrible kick gives him some good field position.
The Vikings offense will start this drive at their own 16-yard line. Diggs didn't haul that one in, and it falls incomplete.
LeBlanc broke up the quick outside pass on that last play by reading it perfectly. No catch. Incomplete.
The defense stood up to that play and shuts down what would be a minimal gain anyway. It'll be second down. Bradford throws a bullet to the flat and they can't connect. Incomplete.
Kyle didn't have anyone on him on that play, but still couldn't make the catch.
If complete, that would have made for a bit shorter third down play, but not much.
Not a lot of potential on that call.
Third down and four wideouts in the game. Number 19 grabs the rope right side, and they get the first on third and long.
First and 10. Ball to Vikings, 34 yards.
Single back, single back.
Number 44 gets the handoff and passes the line. Brought down at the 34.
Just like it is, we're going to execute, and we're going to stay strong, and we're going to get to the spots we need to. Okay, fellas?
They're going air. They're going air.
Second and nine.
Let's run.
Oh, Vikings, 34-yard line.
McMahon makes a play on this and forces the incompletion.
McMahon came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
On second down, they try for the first, but it's played well by the defense. That will bring up third down.
Nice pressure that time.
Third down, one man back. Bradford rifles it out left side, and they can't connect. Incomplete. Number 18 gets ready to punt this away. Number 18 takes the snap and punts it away. Royal gets it at the 24. Back down at the 32.
Royal racked up a few yards on the run back there, whittling down the size of the punt a little bit.
The Bears stalled early last drive, and we'll have to wait and see what happens here. They'll start at their 32-yard line. Number 17 goes in motion. Number 6 throws a bullet, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Rhodes came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
That had potential for some yards, Peter, but the defense was on top of it and shut it down.
Good denial there.
Second down coming up. Second down with the tight end right. Number 33 gets the call on second down and picks up a couple.
We stop them right here and right now.
Ball of the Bears, 34-yard line.
Motion!
Back 44! Back 44!
Number 6 floats this one out to the right sidelines, and it is not reeled in. Incomplete.
Terrence Newman was on that fly ball on that last play like glue. Man, he knew where the pass was going, and he stopped it. Incomplete.
Well, the knee holds tight on third and long and forces an incompletion. That was a good call by the defensive coordinator.
Oh, it sure was. Perfect D for that situation.
And it will bring up fourth down. Number 16 lines up to punt after the three and out. Number 16 gets the ball and punts it away. Stopped at the 40.
Number 35 ran it back for a solid gain. That was a good punt, but he really made up for it.
The Vikings haven't got much out of their offense recently, and we'll see if they can get back on track here. This drive begins at their 40-yard line. Freeman tackles him behind the line of scrimmage.
Freeman was a one-man wrecking crew back there. He powered into the backfield and made the tackle.
They put a stop to this play behind the line of scrimmage. Pretty good call by the defensive coordinator.
Agreed, Dan. They had it all locked up there.
That will bring up second down. Number 44 gets the call again and will lose about a yard here.
Number 59 targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
That will be two losses in a row.
Great reads by the D on the last two plays, Dan. Floyd brought down the ball carrier before the markers. There was some gain there, but not enough for the first.
That's his third tackle of the game. Number 18 lines up for the punt.
Number 19 to make the return.
Number 18 takes the long snap and punts it away. Royal catches it at the 14. tackled at the 26.
Royal did a nice job getting some yards after fielding the solid punt.
The Bears have had some trouble moving the ball recently. We'll see what they do on this drive as they start at their own 26-yard line. Number 81 goes in motion. Number 6 fires this one over the middle, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Terrence Newman got himself in prime position to bat away that football before the receiver even had a shot at it.
Another batted ball, and they have been attacking the pass every chance they get.
That's right, Dan. You know, why simply defend the pass when you can obliterate it?
Hurst tips it away on the coverage. Incomplete.
Curse came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
A nice defensive play will give him his second batted ball of the game.
Yeah, great read there.
Third down from the shotgun. Number 6 puts his arm into this one, and it's tipped. Incomplete. It'll be fourth down.
Smith managed to disrupt things. He got in there and he smacked that pass away. Great D.
That's his third batted ball. And he is doing his part, that is for sure.
Nice to see aggressive D like that, Dan.
Number 16 lines up to punt after the three and out. Number 16 gets the ball and punts it away. Number 35 fields the deep punt at the 30. Dragged down at the 34.
Number 35 got pinned deep by a beauty of a kick there, and by the time he looked up, there was nowhere to go.
The Vikings will start this drive at their 34-yard line. Bradford zings it to the right side, and it's incomplete. Second down, both tight ends left. Number 44 takes his 16th carry of the game and chews up about 4 on the play. Throws a heater right sideline, and they get the first on third and long.
Charles Johnson is in man-to-man coverage on this play and makes the most of it. Let's take a look. Oh, that's a great catch. That guy has real skills.
That's broken kind of a cold streak for him. The last two passes his way were incomplete.
Yeah, let's see if he stays on track.
Number 44 gets the call on first down and picks up a couple.
Number 50 with the tackle.
Second down from the eye.
Ball at the 45.
Rhino!
Number 44 picks up 6 on the play, and that will bring up third down.
Number 44 took advantage of some really good blocking there on that last run. When you get the initial surge like that, good things happen, especially in the ground game.
Peter, he can get free in that matchup.
Well, obviously, we just saw it. He way outmatched his man.
And that'll do it for the third quarter. The Vikings are out in front 14-10. Diggs goes in motion. Number 44 will get the carry on third down and lowers his shoulder for the first.
Number 44 lowered his shoulder on that play and created some extra yards.
A nice play, and with only a short distance to the first, they put it together and make it happen.
Yeah, third and short always looks easy, but it's not, Dan. That's good execution.
number 44, goes right up the middle and will gain close to six. Second down, tight end to the left. Number 44 gets the handoff and heads out right. Tackled at the 28.
Number 29 with the tackle.
Play action, play action.
Third and one. Ball at the 28-yard line.
Loosey, loosey, loosey.
Bradford rifles it out left side, and it is not reeled in. Incomplete.
Young closed in from the zone and forced the incompletion.
That was a fantastic job by the defense to stop what would have been a first down.
I love to see Big D on third and short situations. Fourth down, defenses love to hear that from the refs.
Fourth down, 1 yard to go. It's through the uprights.
Number three kicks the field goal, but watch how close the ball gets to the upright. Man, a few more inches and he'd have made the highlight reel. Not the way he would have wanted to, though.
Number three kicking off for the Vikings.
There's the signal, and we're ready. Number three kicks it off. Bellamy catches it back at the two. Brought down at the 22.
Bellamy got a very respectable return off that nice kickoff there, Dan.
The Bears haven't got much out of their offense recently, and we'll see if they can get back on track here. This drive begins at their own 22-yard line. To the left, and he's got the first down and a whole lot more.
Number six threw the pass into double coverage, but gets his man perfectly. Hey, that was one accurate throw.
What a pass, and he is generating some great numbers.
Oh, absolutely, Dan. So far, he's got 241 yards and one touchdown. Oh, look there, 150 plus receiving yards. He's been making plays all game long.
Number 17 goes in motion. Number 6 just rifles this one, and the catch is made for a gain of a couple.
Number 17 made a fantastic catch in double coverage. Keep getting him the ball, guys.
We've been saying his name a lot today, and with good reason. He has not slacked off at all.
And he's finishing really strong, too.
Second down with a split backfield. This one will fall incomplete.
Number six apparently thought those two defenders patrolling the zone were doing something else, like looking for a contact lens or something. Boy, he's lucky it was just an incomplete pass.
Not much success to be had on the right side for this passing game, Peter. They have been off over there.
Yeah, I'd go somewhere else if I were them. Johnson tackled him so close to the markers, he can probably taste it, and along with the dirt and the grass he's trying to spit out.
There's a migraine waiting to happen for a defensive coordinator. They almost gave it up.
Yeah, but they didn't let him convert. It's still going to go to fourth down.
Fourth and short. Number 16 gets ready to punt this away. Number 16 takes the long snap and punts it away. The Vikings send their offense out on the field and will start this drive at their own 20-yard line. Number 44 takes his 22nd carry of the game and will end up losing a bunch here.
Freeman was a one-man wrecking crew back there. He powered into the backfield and made the tackle.
That will be his fourth tackle of the contest. Johnson goes in motion. Higgs makes the catch Yardage on the right sideline, and that's good for six. Number
21. Bradford dissected the double coverage with a pass that was prettier than a stadium full of cheerleaders.
Another short pass, and he likes that area of the field so far.
And why not? He's had success there.
Bradford zings it to the right side, and it's tipped. Incomplete. Fourth down coming up.
Freeman got himself in prime position to bat away that football before the receiver even had a shot at it.
It seemed like the defense read that one from the beginning, and they forced the incompletion with relative ease.
Beautiful call by the D coordinator.
It'll be fourth down. Number 18 lines up to punt after the three and out. Number 18 takes the snap and punts it away. Royal fields the punt at the 34. Hammered down at the 42. It looks like, we've had an injury down on the field. As soon as we hear anything, we'll be sure to pass the information along to you. The Bears haven't got much out of their offense recently, and we'll see if they can get back on track here. This drive begins at their 42-yard line. Number 17 goes in motion. Number 33 will get the carry on first down and will lose about a yard here.
Barr not only cleaned the ball carrier's clock in the backfield, but buffed and polished it too. Big hit for a loss.
They put a stop to this play behind the line of scrimmage. Pretty good call by the defensive coordinator.
Agreed, Dan. They had it all locked up there.
That will bring up second down. This pass will fall harmlessly to the ground, and it's incomplete.
Number 17 looked like he had a solid catch there, and yet somehow he found a way to drop it.
That's two drops by one of the more sure-handed receivers in the game.
Wow, it's not often you see him out of sync like this.
Wow, look at those tackles. That's how you play sideline to sideline. Rhodes brought down the ball carrier before the markers. There was some gain there, but not enough for the first.
They stopped them cold. Fourth coming up.
Exactly what this defense needed to do.
Fourth down, and the punting unit is on the field. Number 16 gets the snap and pummels this one deep. The Vikings stalled early last drive, and we'll have to wait and see what happens here. They'll start at their own 20-yard line. Number 44 bulldozes right of center and rambles for about five. Wayne had to leave the field earlier in the game, and now Susie Kalber has a report. Susie?
Thank you, Dan. I got in touch with the trainers, and right now all they know is that his knee is in heaps of pain. They're looking at him right now. He seems to be in serious pain. The official word on his return, doubtful. Back to you, Dan.
Thanks, Susie. Diggs catches the heater left sideline, and he's just barely past the markers for a first.
Diggs is all by himself, and he'll take advantage of it. Easy catch.
I'm glad he finally nabbed one, because he's had a string of missed catches before this.
Yeah, his quarterback obviously didn't lose faith in him, though, Dan, because he's kept throwing it his way.
Number 44 picks up about two, and that will bring up second down.
Second and eight. All the Vikings, 33-yard line.
Single back. Not 14. Not 19.
No good. Incomplete.
Number 44 had that ball in his hands on that play, and then he just dropped it.
He couldn't hold on to that one, and maybe that's why they don't throw to him that often.
No, he's more of a runner than a target out of the backfield.
Third down and four wideouts in the game.
Single back.
Bradford throws a heater, and this one is incomplete.
Number 11 had some room on the fringes there, but couldn't reel in the pass.
Heater in third down situations, they have not been successful at all with the pass. This play was more proof.
Boy, third is such a crucial down, Dan. And when you don't convert, it really hurts.
Number 18 lines up for the punt. Number 18 takes the long snap and punts it away. Breaks a tackle. Tackled at the 48.
Royal gets some congratulations from his special teams coach on this one. See, he makes the catch, and now he's off to get some more good yards and help his team out with field position. Good play.
The Bears' offense takes the field with time winding down. They'll start at their 48-yard line. The 43.
Number 6 decided at the last moment to scramble back there, and it worked out.
Second down and less than a yard.
Ball at the 43.
Number 33 takes this one way out left and barely picks up the first down. Number 33 goes in motion. Number 6 uncorks this to the left sideline, and it's not reeled in. Incomplete.
Green kept both eyes on the short out on that one and caused the incomplete pass.
That had potential for some yards, Peter, but the defense was on top of it and shut it down.
Good denial there.
Second down coming up. Eventually slides down at the 30. It will be first down.
Number 6 had no one to throw to, so he just tucked it under and went for it. It's worth another look. If it wasn't for that scramble, he would have been toast.
First down, two tight ends in the game. First down, the clock is stopped at 2 minutes.
Down! Check gray 14! Check gray 14! Hut!
Number 33 carries this one off to the right, and he's stopped. The clock continues to run.
Number 33 used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
He's been going wide right a lot today and hasn't been getting too far.
He's getting beaten to the punch, Dan. He needs to use his blockers better.
Number 33 has his number called on second down and rambles for about 5.
Look at the numbers generated on the ground. That is impressive.
Number 6 rifles it out left side, and the catch is made for the first. The clock continues to tick down. First down, goal to go. Number 33 takes the handoff and runs into traffic. Tackled, and the clock will continue to run.
Number 22 with the tackle. Second and goal. Ball at the 9.
Number 6 ropes this one to the end zone, and it's caught for a touchdown.
Number 17 chases down 2 defenders and comes away with the football. Oh, nice catch.
That's his second TD reception, and obviously The passes are coming his way when they get in the red zone.
Well, he's taken on the role of scorer today, Dan, and I got to tell you, he's filling that role nicely.
Number four lines up to tie the game. Now the point after, and it's good. There's the signal, and we're ready. Number four rockets this one deep. This will fly out of the end zone for a touchback. What a kick.
Look, Dan, great receiving yards there. That will help your fantasy team.
The Vikings take their first timeout. First down, the clock is stopped at 30. Bradford throws a heater right sideline, and it's caught at the 46, 15, and touchdown.
Charles Johnson is going to make a great play right here. Snags the football and then really turns on the juice.
Not a player who typically has a TD on his stats, but he's able to run it in after making the completion.
Oh, that's why I love this game, Dan. Anybody can suddenly break loose on you and light things up.
Number 67, holding.
Now the point after, and it's good.
Number three, kicking off for the Vikings.
The ref gets the signal, and we're set. Number three rockets this one deep. Thompson downs this in the end zone for a touchback. The Bears will start this drive deep in their own territory with the clock at 19. Barr makes a play on this and forces the incompletion.
Barr came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
He records yet another batted ball, and I'll tell you, he's really playing well out there.
Yeah, he's been after the ball from the beginning of the game. Real aggressive play.
Second down. The clock is stopped at 16. Number six throws this on a rope, and it falls incomplete.
Rhodes did a beautiful job on that last play covering the post route. That pass never had a chance. Incomplete.
On second down, they try for the first, but it's played well by the defense. That will bring up third down.
Nice pressure that time.
Third down, one man back. Number 33 catches it over the middle. The Bears take their first timeout.
Last down, last down.
Single back. And I got 17.
Down.
I'm not winning.
Check. 44.
Number six. Rifles it out left side, and it falls incomplete. They will turn the ball over on downs.
Bellamy. Well, Dan, they had to have liked the call, but I don't think they liked the result. Watch the replay here. He couldn't quite haul that one in. Tough mid-range incompletion.
That was some aggressive play calling that deep in their own territory, and it may have cost them dearly.
I just don't see how they were in four down mode there, especially at their end of the football field. That's a bad call. Well, this game is already over, Dan. Even though the D can stop the clock twice,
Right there. Down. Check.
And that will do it for tonight's game. The Vikings come out on top 24-17. For my partner, Peter O'Keefe, this is Dan Stevens saying goodbye until next time.
All right, gang, great work as always. And with that, we welcome everybody back to the ESPN studios for our ESPN Video Games post-game show. I'm Chris Berman. The Vikings stepped it up for sure, putting up some good numbers. Let's get started in this one early in the third quarter. Number 17 came up with a big play as he was able to pull this one in. A 51-yard touchdown for the Bears. The Bears climb back again and are now down by four. The ball at their own 32-yard line. Number 6 would find his target on this one. An 18-yard play that set up a bare field goal, but they couldn't connect. The Vikes, after a missed field goal, Vikes ahead by 4. Number 21 would come up with the big play to kill a drive as he was able to step in front of a wayward pass for an INT. The Vikes again have it. Number 8 connected with his man on this one. Vikes out in front, 14-10. After driving 38 yards on 9 plays, number 3 would come on and connect on the field goal try. A 46-yard field goal. Number 6 is back to throw. This is nothing more than a little pitch and catch with his wide receiver. Bears down by 7. Number 6 would put this pass right where it needed to be. They knot it up, 17 all. The Vikes answer right back. Charles Johnson emerged as a real weapon as he pulled one in here. A 60-yard touchdown for the Vikings. And that's where we'll leave this one. Vikes squeaked out a win, 24-17. Now let's catch up with the player who really ignited his team's offense with his deft passing and has earned our Player of the Game award. Number 8 is on the sidelines with Susie Colbert. Susie?
Thank you, Chris. You excelled under pressure today. You may have the ingredient your team needed to pull out a win here. What do you think was vital to your team's success today?
Yeah, you know, for the moment I stepped on the field, man, no one was stopping me. I felt I could win this game for us, and that's what I did.
Chris, back to you.
That winds up our broadcast of the NFL preseason on ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports for 25 years and counting. I'm Chris Berman. Thanks for joining us.